latest in submarine technology, opens the underwater door scientists could only dream of before.
We found probably 100 miles of deep water coral reef that we didn't know was there.
There's another Chase Young fin eye.
Undiscovered territory right off of Florida's coast.
It's a vast ocean out there. So many things have been capturing our imaginations for years and continue today. Researchers now say there may be some medical breakthroughs just waiting for us out there in the ocean depths.
They're retrieving samples from depths of well over 1,000 to 2,000 feet, believing those samples just might unlock secrets to battling deadly diseases.
Why does this deep water sponge like this one, you know, make a compound that could cure human cancer?
Mind-boggling and a lot of work.
Determine what that sponge is. Put a name on it.
First gathering and identifying sponges in the blackness of deep water. Then pulverizing the sample to figure out what they're really made of.
It's dark and it's cold and there's high pressure. And so they make different compounds than those in shallow water.
This would be sample number 7.
Most of our work is in cancer, so we're looking for treatments for cancer.
She believes creatures of the deep could bring us answers which have eluded us until now.
We think maybe they'll block the spread of the tumor, or that maybe once the tumor has spread, they'll actually attack those cells preferentially.
There's some large colonies here.
The magic extends beyond the ability to reach reefs in extremely deep water. It's knowing that once a combination of ingredients found in that deep water shows success in treating disease, it can be reproduced artificially in labs. It's already being done at the Burnham Institute right here in Orlando.
They've made one of our compounds, and they can make a lot of that compound in the laboratory, so we never have to go back and recollect that sponge.
These are good 4 to 5 foot tall.
I would like to think maybe in the next decade some of these compounds would actually start to really move forward and be available for treatment.
The test will also look at potential treatments for West Nile, malaria, other tropical diseases. Wonderment, yes, and possibly life-saving. Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.